Hurricane Katrina hit August of 2005. By December 2005, schools were still closed, the city was still underwater, there were still live wires, the evacuation was still underway. There was no revenue, there was no economic activity, and the Orleans Parish School Board at that time fired the entire school district. Bus drivers, janitors, teachers, teacher aides, it just shut down. In January, February of 2006, the state came in and said to the city, you can't get your act together to start reopening these schools. It's understandable, but you can't, so we're going to do it. So the state took over schools in the early 2006. Well, guess what? State departments of education are not designed to run schools. They're designed to administer tests, to disperse funds, to put records, to accredit schools, but they don't like know how to plan a cafeteria menu or set up a school bus schedule. So the state floundered around for a long time as well. In 2007, Paul was asked to come down and fix it because it had been such a mess. And by June of 2007, people were really now starting to come back. FEMA money was starting to flow a little bit, and people were starting to come home. So Paul got there in June, and they knew that September, June 7, 2007, the 2007-08 school year was going to be the first like real school year that had happened since Katrina. So they were in a panic to get schools open. Paul got there in June, and he had like 2.5, 3 months to do it. Every single school teacher that lost his or her job was invited to come back. Only a portion of them did. Some retired, some got other jobs in other places, sometimes within Louisiana. Some of them just decided to stay wherever it was they evacuated to, Mississippi or Atlanta. But every teacher was offered their job back. And then Paul filled in the gaps with Teach for America, because it's a kind of an apprentice program, because they had to get the schools open. But there is an urban myth out there that Ballas fired all the African American school teachers in New Orleans and replaced them with white teachers. And it drives me crazy, because it's been said and repeated and reprinted and reblogged and retexted and retweeted so many times. And I'm not going to go into who or why, but Teach for America and charter schools are sort of non-unionized, so you can probably imagine where that threat came. But I was asked to clear that up because I had talked, and it's out there. If you Google it, you'll see it's on the internet. Paul fired all the teachers in New Orleans. Paul didn't get to New Orleans until 2007, and when he left in 2012, they gave him the key to the city. Thank you.